Yeah. So that style not for you, but it's for me.
Greenfield's finest. Boss.
Yeah.
DJ Drama.
Never let a wishbone grow where backbone should. Belly been tell you to dash on wood.
The mantra, and off we go. We're underway in this NFC wildcard game. Fields it right around the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. So here come the Falcons now to get the football for the first time. Bringing him out is the future Hall of Famer. Now in his 18th NFL season, Aaron Rodgers. They go play action here on first down. And his first pass here is going to fall incomplete.
One thing you have to see out of a rookie tight end is a real concentration when the ball's in the air. And I'm not sure that he didn't, but he has to be prepared for people making a play on it when that ball's up for grabs.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Now Rodgers. And this one taken in on the right sideline, but not in the field of play. They say it's incomplete. The throw led him a little too far, brings up third down.
Well, so far in this drive, they've done some good work. They force incompletions on first and second down, bring up third and 10. That brings up the big question. Do they bring pressure, or do they play coverage on this down?
Throwing is Rodgers on third down. This is White on the screen. And that's not going to get it done. He'll come up well short of the first at about the 21. Only 2 yards, and it'll be a punt on their opening possession. Fourth down, so Jake Camarda is out there. And he'll get this away into the icy winter air. Pulled in at the 24. It'll be a 51-yard punt that time. And the Commanders will take over with a first and 10. Here are the Commanders for their first drive of the game. And they'll be led out by the second overall pick from BYU, now in his second season, Zach Wilson. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. First play of the drive going for 14 and also going for a first down.
Good running right there. And this is a man who's a 1,000-yard rusher in the regular season, so you know he's going to get his chances. And he picks up nice yardage on that one.
It's Kenneth Walker. And a pretty good burst there as he'll get this across midfield and down to the 46. 12 yards is the pickup, and it's good for a Washington first down. A perfect example right there, Charles, of why they love this rookie runner.
And think about how the NFL and the college games are meshing together more and more. You don't have to go to the NFL and learn a new set of skills. What you did in college often makes you ready for the NFL.
And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. Jimmy Moreland in there to bring him down. You don't see that a ton, do you? A cornerback coming over to the middle of the field to make a run tackle.
That's someone with a ton of confidence to feel like nothing is pressuring him on his side of the field. Sees that the ball's moved to the middle and just sprints over there to help out. He ends up getting the tackle. Well played.
9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with third and one. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Trying to pick it up on the ground with Harris. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. They give him 16 yards there, and it's a Washington first down. Solid running there. And, CD, we hear so much about what it takes to win in the playoffs. Most people like to include having a strong running game in their assessment. And with this man in the backfield, this group has a strong running game, without a doubt.
Oh, I absolutely agree with you there, because in terms of yardage, he's a top five running back in the league. And in terms of impact on a game, not many better than him. And when they're flowing and he's carrying the ball consistently, they're tough to beat.
On second down, they'll run it here. 9 yards on the play there, and it'll set him up first and goal.
Usually we see runs like this as the defense breaks down later in the game, but this guy set the tone early, running through all types of tackles and put the defense back on its heels.
So first and goal, and an opportunity for our first points in this wild card game. A run with Harris out of the shotgun, and a short pickup there down to about the 9. Only a yard on the pickup there. Second and goal. Defensively, pretty good start there with their backs against the wall.
That's a win for the stop troops right there. And if I'm them, I get a little bolder now. They won the first battle. Keep coming after them. Put the pressure.
And he fights his way into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Ty Davis Price. A 9-yard touchdown run. And the Commanders will strike first here in this wild card matchup. Extra point by McPherson, up and good, and it's now a 7-0 game. So that drive consumes 9 plays all told. And it was capped off by the touchdown run from Ty Davis Price. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. Taking it about the 1. Here's Richie James on the return. And he had no room to run as he's tackled down inside the 20. So out come the Falcons now. One semi-factor, if you want to call it that, that was brought up in the papers this morning here, Charles. You got a dome team on the road in a cold weather environment, first round of the playoffs in January. Do you think that's a big deal?
Ordinarily, I say no. But in this situation, because you're used to that perfectly controlled environment, some coaches will want their teams exposed to it. If you're coming from a warm weather place, and, you know, even getting outside of your dome doesn't really help you. A lot of times they'll go on the road a little bit earlier. Go to a cold weather place, go to a place where there's a little bit of weather, and practice there that week before the game to try and simulate the conditions they expect come game day.
And some room to run now. The 40, 30, and all the way down to the 17-yard line. 64 yards rushing for him now as he has gotten the night off to a hot start. So that run there, you know, I don't know if it's overstating things to call it a thing of beauty, but in terms of football plays, that's as good as you're going to see. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. Able to locate Andrews here on the out route. Touchdown, Falcons! Mark Andrews from 17 yards out. And the Falcons are an extra point away from evening this one up. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are tied at 7. Scoring summary. 3-play drive. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. And it's Mark Andrews who finishes things off with a touchdown reception. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone. So we will start here at the 25. The Commanders going to retake the field for drive number 2. And now last drive, so successful with the ground game, ending in a touchdown. Do you stick with that formula?
That would be the number one thing you would think of, but so many guys now would look at it and say, we've got them set up so well for play action, now's the time to take a shot.
Yeah.
But, you know, there was a big-time coach in the state of Ohio who once said, if you throw the ball, if you put it in the air, 3 things can happen, and 2 of them are bad. He would have kissed it on the ground.
Room here to run. And it's a big play there as he is finally taken down on what will be a terrific final act of this first quarter. These two teams all tied after 1. Second quarter now from our nation's capital, and it's Washington in possession of the football as they go to work on a first and goal.
Come on, set.
Harris is into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington. Nice job of polishing off that drive, but all the credit there goes to that play prior.
Yeah, it certainly does, because after that big play, I think resistance almost felt futile at that point, didn't it? And the very next play, they come right back, quick, fast, and in a hurry, and put it in the end zone.
After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now the Falcons offense, they get ready to head back out here. They trail a one-score deficit, 14-7, as they come up first and 10. Rodgers now to throw. And that is incomplete. Oh, the coverage a little too good there, and it's second down.
They certainly thought he had an open look beyond the first down marker to his receiver, but they just couldn't connect, and that will send them back to the drawing board.
To throw on second and 10, Rodgers. He's got his man, it's Andrews. He'll be dropped after a gain of about 6 across the 30 to the 31. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
An extra man in the secondary for Washington on third down. Now Rodgers. Got a man, that's Richie James. And brought down, but not before reaching the 45-yard line. His first catch of this wild card game, and it's good for a first down.
Third and 4 is always a tough call. Maybe a little too long to run for it, but not too long to hit him on the quick slant. And that was well executed. Found the window and zipped it right in there.
Throwing on first down is Rodgers. He completes this to Russell Gage. Now he's going to get this all the way down inside the 35. First catch of this wild card game for a 1,000-yard receiver in the regular season. He's got a first down, too. A give up the middle to Carter. And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple, and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
The last run got a couple. Here's second and 8. They'll go again with Carter. Oh, he's got a little daylight. And a hard-working run here as he's got it inside the 20, down to the 17. 80 yards rushing for him in this first half as he has certainly carried over his regular season success into the playoffs. Well, he's broken off some big-time runs here in this first half.
Ben, let's just face it. When you go into a game, you think you've got the plays that are going to work, but when you actually get out there and they're starting to happen, your confidence rises, and he's running with terrific ability right now.
That one almost intercepted, but it's incomplete. Not a good throw there, and it'll be second down.
That certainly appeared to be a play call where they were just trying to make second down, second and short. I think they thought the coverage was off a little bit more than it was. Nice job there pressing up on it and forcing the incompletion.
On second down, a run with Carter. And he'll take it into the end zone. Touchdown, Atlanta. Michael Carter from 17 yards out. And the Falcons are within an extra point of tying up this ball game. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and we are tied at 14. So that one, an 8-play drive. It spans 75 yards. This one tied at 14 now as he sends this one away. Takes it at the 7. And he's going to get this across the 20 as he's out of bounds at the 23. Washington ready to try again on offense. Right now, we've got a little bit of an offensive masterpiece going on. Both sides moving the football, scoring points. It's almost like somebody put the defense on rookie mode in this one. I mean, we haven't even left the first half, Charles, and we're certainly on pace for a shootout.
An excellent start for both offenses. The fans have to be enjoying this to see all these points go up on the board. As a former defender, you know I'm not enjoying this at all. But right now, both these teams just trading haymakers. Let's see if anyone slips up first. Can anyone counter with a nice little jab and get things going in their direction?
And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35.
Holding offense.
That's on the guard, Lakin Tomlinson. They'll come up now on a second and long after the hold. On second down, it's Walker. Oh, he's got some breathing room. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. That one good for 37 yards. And that one heck of a run right there. Once he got loose, you could tell that he was going to run a long way. That was pretty impressive. Davis Price on first and 10. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. 11 more yards that go around, a first down as well. First down, and they go right back to Davis Price. A solid stiff arm. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. Another big hitter there. This one good for 18.
They're making it look easy out there. Another first down. So far on this drive, let me do this little bit of math here. Four plays, three first downs.
That's a pretty good recipe for success. Now a first down carry for Harris. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
This drive is pretty clear. Almost feels like old school fundamentals, doesn't it? Want to impose their will on the defense. What's that, 5 straight runs?
Yeah, 5 straight carries to start this drive. And like you said, the way it's working, they may just stick with it. They're looking at a second and 8 now from the 10. Up the middle, here's Walker. And he's in. Touchdown, Commanders. Kenneth Walker, a 10-yard touchdown run. And Washington has taken the lead. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead is now 21-14. That time, a 6-play drive. And it was Kenneth Walker finishing things off with a touchdown run. After the touchdown, McPherson on to kick this one away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. Atlanta now coming out on the field. They'll look for a drive to tie this up, down 21-14 as they have it first and 10. Throwing now is Rodgers. He'll drop that down to Carter underneath. He's going to be dropped following a pickup of 7 past the 30 to the 32. To throw again on second down, Rodgers. And this is going to be hauled in by the tight end, Andrews. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. Rodgers now on first down. And the throw left sideline here is caught, but they'll rule it incomplete. Couldn't keep his feet in. Second down. So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. Rodgers to throw once more. And he's left with no option here but to throw it away.
Feels like they're getting caught in between here because they didn't completions on first and second down. Now you got to worry a little bit about the clock because you prefer not to give them another shot here in the first half. If you don't pick up the first down, guess what? You're likely going to have to.
And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over a minute to go before halftime. Rodgers now on first down. Here's White. They set up the screen. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Now another timeout called for by the offense as they get the stoppage with a little over 50 seconds to go in the first half. And again, it's Rodgers. Another catch by White. Back-to-back plays. And he'll be brought down at about the 23-yard line.
Well, they certainly made a point of getting him involved in the passing game here in the first half. They must have seen something in the scouting that said, hey, we can capitalize on him getting the ball, possibly in the open field. And I think in the second half, that may loosen up the defense a little bit to get the running game going back inside.
On first and 10, here's Rodgers. Throw right side complete to Carter. Falcons going to use their third and final timeout as they stop it with 16 seconds to go in half number one.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively, offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take
it. He's got a man complete. Now a timeout taken. Perhaps a chance for one more quick play and then another timeout if they hurry. We'll see. 39 yards there, a big one. So how about that for a chain mover? They're all the way down inside the 40 now for first and 10. Walker now on first and 10. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. Now whistles and a timeout with 3 seconds left in the first half. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On as the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This officially a 55-yard attempt. And he has got it from 55 yards away. A look around the NFL. We'll have to wait for postgame because we are moving right through halftime and on to the third quarter. And we welcome you back now alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, getting set for quarter number 3 here. One of these two teams about to play their final half of the season as we're back at it in this NFC wildcard bout. And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The Washington offense ready to go to begin the third quarter. And they're in the position they expected to be in. They've got the lead, home crowd behind them, and they're looking toward making that next step in these playoffs.
And I think a key for them is to put together some good, long, extended drives. Work the run in a little more with that big offensive line. I'm not saying get away from throwing the football. That's still working. But if they run it more effectively, they may get even bigger plays in the passing game.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Harris running straight ahead, and he'll be upended at the 33 following a gain of 3. And guess what? It brings up third down.
Well, praise has to go to the guys on the offensive line because they've had a very nice, productive day running the football. How about that poor defensive line? They've been knocked around the entire game, and while they slowed him down on that run, can they continue to do so? Because they haven't had much success throughout this ball game.
And he's going to have a Commanders first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
A run on first down, but it's not going to get them much. Maybe a yard, and that's all.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They've won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left them no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
Second down, here's Davis Price. And he'll be brought down right on the 50, a gain of 3.
Typically, we think it's the strong safeties that are better tacklers, especially closer to the line of scrimmage amidst traffic. But in this case, how about the free safety coming up and making the big-time play?
On third down, here's Walker. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. 97 yards for him on the ground now. He has been a tough man to bring down all night.
Brandon, they're still in the lead. The momentum's certainly been going the opposite direction. So to me, that's a really important pickup there on third down.
Try and regain some confidence. And you're right, they need to stem the tide a little bit. That certainly helped.
On the give, this is Harris. And he's got some space here. And he's able to motor his way down to the 16-yard line. Another strong gain on the last two plays. They've moved it a combined 33 yards. All runs on this drive so far. It's first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Harris again. And he'll be stopped after a gain of only a couple down to the 15-yard line.
Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
Here's a handoff out of the gun. He takes this down to about the 12 for a gain of 3.
Let's give a lot of credit to the offensive line. They've been able to move the ball really well on the ground the entire game. And while that wasn't a huge one, that's okay. They'll take them in short, steady bursts.
Up the middle they run. It's Walker. And they're going to drop him well shy of the first as he can only make it to the 11. Just a yard on the run there. And that's going to bring us to a fourth down. McPherson's kick is good, and that will extend their lead even further.
Well, they picked up right where they left off in the first half. First drive after the break, they come away with 3 and increase that lead.
Yeah, and you just want to keep building on that lead, don't you? Whether it's 6 points or 3 points, take everything you can get, keep maneuvering, keep adding to it, keep making it difficult for them to come back.
Here comes the Falcons offense. It's their first possession of the second half now.
Their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
Gonna let one fly for Robinson. Pass incomplete, but the flag in the backfield, and this might be a roughing call.
Personal foul. Roughing the passer. Defense.
So, roughing the passer penalty, never one that you like to see.
Not at all, and especially when you're in that final push of the season. You can't afford to get your quarterback hurt before the playoffs roll around, and we know they'll be here before you know it.
On first down, Rodgers. And the hook up here to Allen Robinson.
And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Well, this is where reading defenses and practice time comes into play. You've got to know what you're running versus zone versus man and how to run the proper route. And they just executed that one pretty well.
Working from the gun, Rodgers.
He'll get that out to the flat to White.
And he'll go out of bounds after taking it a little further down inside the 40. So the completion results there in 9 yards. And it'll bring up a second and short.
Just about every quarterback is trained to really look downfield first before you come back and make a nice safe throw. And in this case, that's exactly what he did. Found his running back, let him create some space, and it turned out to be a nice play for the offense.
And the stop here will come at the 38-yard line. Able to get the 1 yard he needed, but nothing more. One quarter remains in this NFC wild card matchup. Back now at FedEx Field. It's the Falcons. They'll have the football, but trailing on the scoreboard as we get set to begin the fourth. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He completes it right side of White. He'll be hit down at the 33, 5 yards on the play.
I know it was a gain, but you have to sense probably a little bit of disappointment there because when it's out there in open space, I think they expect to get more out of a play, don't you?
Especially when you're getting it to your guy out of the backfield. You're expecting him to be able to create something, be a little more shifty.
Yeah, no doubt about it. Good open field tackling held it to an okay game.
Rodgers' throw taken in by Ridley here. And they're going to move it down inside the 25.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. Shotgun now for Rodgers. His throw incomplete.
He didn't just deny a big throw there. He broke that one up in the red zone. An excellent play, one that may help save points on the board when this drive is over.
From the 24, they'll go again on second and 10. Rodgers gonna throw. Wide open receiver complete. And they do get him down, but not before he's able to slip it inside the 5-yard line. An excellent pickup of 20 yards. White will get about halfway there as he takes this from the 4 down to the 2. It's a gain of a couple, and it'll be second and goal.
Well, they certainly had success throwing the ball on this drive, and not as much running it as we just saw once again on that last play, stopped after a very short gain. But I wouldn't abandon the run totally, because otherwise, pass rushers just tee off on your quarterback. Makes it very, very difficult for him in that situation.
Two runs in a row, but only 2 yards to show for it. This is a big play in this wild card matchup, facing third and goal. They fake the give. Now Rodgers toward the end zone, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
That was a touchdown if he could have hung on. Instead, it was a well-timed collision to jar that one free.
And Gay knocks this one through, and this is back down to a 7-point game. All right, so they needed 2 scores to get back in the game. The field goal there, maybe not exactly what they wanted, but the necessary first step.
There's still time remaining, and there's enough time to get it done. They've got to get at the least a 3-and-out here to get the ball back, preferably a takeaway.
Here comes the Commanders' offense back onto the field. And right now, they're just looking for a little more cushion, trying to make this a 2-score game. Points here would go a long way, obviously, to propelling them into the next round.
And this is where the head coach, offensive coordinator, they've had to set a tone all year long about what they do on offense. So most teams want to stay in attack mode, but you have to do it with some bit of caution, don't you? Because you can't come away with no points. You need these points here in order to feel a lot better about where they are in this game.
But this time of the year, playoffs, game of this magnitude, this is what we hope for.
Yeah, it's exactly what we hope for. You want to run your offense cautiously, but not so cautiously that you just give it up.
And he makes it all the way down to the 13-yard line. 195 yards on the ground for him now, as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on.
Well, it is our business to analyze what we saw out there. And on that play, I saw a defense staying in base, not taking a chance, not blitzing in a situation when they absolutely need the football back. That's either a case of overthinking it or not thinking it through.
If you do blitz, do you have to be careful about where you're coming from, or are you just coming from all angles?
You have to be careful about where you're coming from, obviously. But at this stage, you have to take a few chances as well.
On second down, this is Harris. And for one of the first times tonight, he's going to be held up at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Straight ahead, Walker. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. Ken Walker, his second touchdown of the night. And the Commanders have opened up a 2-touchdown lead here this fourth quarter. Extra point by McPherson, up and good. And the lead now up to 14. That time, 75-yard drive, 5 plays. And it was Ken Walker finishing things off with a touchdown run. Fields it right around the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. Here comes the Atlanta offense now ready to take over here.
If they want to advance in this divisional round, look, obviously the time is now. Trailing here in the fourth as they go to work on a crucial, crucial drive, first and 10.
From the gun, it's Rodgers. They go with a shuffle pass, and it's complete. And down right around the 32-yard line, 4 yards on the pickup. Short play like that in this situation this late, that's a win for the defense.
No doubt. I remember something Coach Madden used to talk about all the time. Sometimes you can't just take what the defense gives you. You have to take what you need. And in this case, the offense is taking what the defense is giving them, not what they need.
So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. To throw, it's Rodgers.
This is Robinson, and they'll get this down to around the 47-yard line.
Rodgers in control as he hurries his guys to the line. Now he dumps this off over the middle,
and he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
First down now, but the clock continues to move. And he will find Ridley. That's complete.
And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought.
Throwing again on second down. Rodgers, and it's complete. Right back to Ridley.
And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 21.
Toward the back corner of the end zone, but he could not get the feet down. This will wind up incomplete. From the 21, it's second and 10. Now it's Rodgers.
A throw to the flat for Carter. And they're going to get this down to about the 17-yard line here.
They'll get to the line here, but remember, it's also third down. And this is intercepted, and that should do it. Picked up by Justin Reed.
And the Commanders are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. Well, field goals probably aren't going to cut it at this point. This was touchdown or bust, and unfortunately for them, it turned out to be bust.
Yeah, they're feeling like they've got to force the issue here. Maybe take some chances they wouldn't have earlier in the game. But give credit to this defense. They've really stood tall throughout, and they come up with the interception in the end zone.
Here we go.
Again, it's Harris on second down.
And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line.
Washington moving on. As we say so long, everybody. Thanks for watching.
I'm the